Students, now we are going to study 9th standard social science. Unit 1, evolution of humans and society, prehistoric period. Learning objectives: to trace the world's early history, to understand human evolution. First, introduction. We live in the age of information technology at present. The mobile phones have literally put the world on our fingertips. The all-encompassing knowledge that we possess now, which has helped in the development of powerful technology, did not emerge all of a sudden. The foundation of our modern life was facilitated by the development of the process of cognition among the human ancestors in the prehistoric age. Cognition. That means the process by which knowledge and understanding is developed in the mind. In Tamil, ullarnda arivu valarchi. Human ancestors, that is, early man and our forefathers. Then prehistoric people were the pioneers of creative knowledge. Pioneers means a people who is one of the first to develop an area of human knowledge from the artifacts and the languages they developed. Artifacts means an object that is made by a person. Object means the early humans, they made a weapons, that is the artifacts. Then we are able to understand how intelligent they were. Then we'll see the origin of the earth and the geological ages. The history of humans is closely related to the history of the earth. The earth contains geological, archaeological and biological records of historical times in its upper layers. They are important for reconstructing the history of the earth and various living organisms. The fossil bones of the human ancestors are embedded in the earth's layer. Fossil, that means, is the naturally preserved remains or traces of animals or plants that lived in the geologic past. Example, footprints. Paleoanthropologists and archaeologists excavate the soil and rock layers on the earth and extract evidence about human ancestors. These layers and the fossils are scientifically dated to study the various stages in human evolution and prehistory. Though the gathered evidence, they attempt to understand the evolution of human history and developments in a chronological order. That means chronological order means historical events arranged in order with the time sequence. Then what is archaeology? Archaeology is a study of human past through the analysis and interpretation of material remains. Interpretation means understanding. Then paleoanthropology is a study of human ancestors and their evolution by the study of the fossil remains. The earth was formed approximately 4.54 billion years ago. Gradually, conditions emerged for the growth of organisms. Then plants and animals came into being, and thereby foundation was laid for the evolution of humans. The long span of time in the history of Earth is divided into eras, periods and epochs by the geologist. And 1 billion equal to 100 crore, 1 million equal to 10 lakh. Then Australopithecines were the apes from which modern humans evolved. Now let us see the geological eras. Look at this picture. It is the Proterozoic era. Proterozoic era. It is primitive multicellular forms appeared. Then Paleozoic era. Here fish, reptiles, plants appeared. Then Mesozoic era. Dinosaurs existed. Then Cenozoic era. Literally southern ape. That is, human beings, they were appeared. So once they were called as a literally southern ape. then human inquiries into the past and origin of the world, the age of speculation, that means theory and opinion of the age, that is the old age, prehistoric age. Humans are the only species on earth concerned with understanding as well as explaining the world and the universe. In the course of evolution, humans became conscious and knowledgeable. They turned curious and began to think and ask questions about nature, organisms and the world around them. At first, they considered nature as a god. Then the lack of scientific knowledge and the creation of the world is reflected in the ancient writing and religious literature. It is a BC, that means commonly it is called before common era, AD or CE, common era. Then scientific foundations of geology, biology and archaeology. The beginning of history writing can be traced to the ancient Greeks. Herodotus was a father of history because the history he wrote was humanistics and rationalistic. That humanistic means the study of human culture, and rationalistic means here based on reason and knowledgeable. In Tamil, we'll say pahuttarivu. Then the rise of scientific inquiry into the origin of humans was possible because of the interest in collection of archaeological remains and the opinion of museums after the Renaissance movement, the development of ideas of stratigraphy and geology, Darwin's theory of biological evolution, the discovery of human and animal fossils, stone tools and artifacts of early civilizations, and the ability to decipher early scripts. Then stratigraphy is a study of origin, nature and relationship of rock and soil layers that were formed due to natural and cultural activities. Then the oldest museum, Ashmolean Museum at Oxford University, is the oldest university museum in the world. It was established in 1677 AD, that is common era. Herbert Spencer, biological evolution, and Charles Darwin's theory on concepts of natural selection and survival of the fittest contributed to the scientific understanding of human origin. Natural selection, the process by which organisms that are better adapted to their environment would survive and produce more offspring. Survival of the fittest means survival of the form that will leave the most copies of itself in successive generations. Fossils, prehistoric animals or plant that turns into stone over a period of time, that means million of years, because of chemical and physical processes. Stone age, the period when stone was mainly used for making implements. Bronze age, the period when bronze metallurgy developed, that is extraction of metal from ores. Then Iron Age, the period when iron was smelted to produce implements. Since the 19th century, scholars have used advanced scientific techniques. They undertook systematic studies to contribute the current state of knowledge and on prehistoric human origins and early civilizations. Okay, children, today revise this part. Then tomorrow we'll see about the prehistoric people, Homo sapiens, Homo erectus to Homo sapiens. Then now do the writing work in your book, what is archaeology, then paleoanthropology, the geological eras, and the origin of humans was possible because of, these are the points you write it, and stratigraphy, then natural selection, survival of the fittest, fossil, stone age, bronze age, iron age, just go through read twice, then only you come to understand. Okay, children.